Today I'm in the woods looking for Mayapple. It's springtime and spring ephemerals are just starting to pop up in the woodlands. I have already found Mayapple. Its scientific name is Podophyllum peltatum. You see, it looks a lot like a small palm tree, about a foot tall off the forest floor. Mayapple is a common rhizomatous perennial herb. And I'd like to break that down into each word. So it's common. It's found in deciduous forests across Eastern America. It's rhizomatous. Rhizomatous means it has rhizomes underground, and that's how it spreads. Well, that's one of the methods it spreads. So if we were to dig underneath the soil, we would likely see an underground stem connecting this plant to this plant, as well as reaching out from this plant onward. And that's one of the ways the Mayapple will reproduce. It's also a perennial. Perennial means that it lives for two or more years. And finally, it's an herb, meaning it does not have a woody stem. Not a woody stem. And it dies down to the ground after it flowers. So come late summer, you likely won't see this here, and the roots will live on until next year. Mayapples produce a fruit. If we look at these, we'll see the beginnings of a flower. Hanging from here is a flower about to burst. After this flower has burst, it'll be pollinated by an insect and it'll produce a fruit. The fruit looks like a small apple and it'll hang down from the bottom of this plant. There are few animals that eat the Mayapple: box turtles, white-tailed deer, and raccoons. Each of these has a slightly different relationship with Mayapple, and we'll talk about the white-tailed deer and the raccoon because there's some research on those two. When a white-tailed deer eats the Mayapple fruit, it eats it before the seeds are fully ripened. Therefore, it doesn't aid the plant in spreading its seeds. So it'll eat that unripe fruit, and then it tends to defecate in areas that are not favorable for the Mayflower. If we look at where this Mayflower is growing, you have a nice colony here, and we're in some pretty dense, shaded forest. Deer tend to defecate out in the open and in drier areas. Another animal that eats Mayflower fruit is the raccoon. And the raccoon eats the fruit when it's ripe. It will destroy some of the seeds. However, it aids spreading the Mayflower seeds because it tends to defecate in areas that are moist and wooded. So we have the box turtle, the white-tailed deer, and the raccoon, all with a different relationship with this one plant. If you live in Eastern America, I encourage you to go out into your woodlands and see if you can find this plant. It's truly unique, and I hope I have inspired you to get outdoors and see some nature. Thanks for watching.